Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshad Devi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be talking to you regarding the vehicles of Buddhism. So I will be talking to you about Hinayana. Hinayana is also known as Theravada sect of Buddhism. However, there are differences between Theravada sect and Hinayana sect, which I will be discussing after some time in this video. Then I will also be talking about Mahayana sect and the Vajrayana sect. One important factor, friends, this Hinayana sect is also known as smaller vehicle. Mahayana sect is known as greater vehicle, and this Vajrayana is also known as Tantrayana. Okay, starting with this thing, friends, you know why these different vehicles of Buddhism has emerged? We need to get to know the reason of this. See, Buddha has taught his teaching for decades, and he had a very close, you know, a union of his close disciples, which was known as Sangha, about which I have already talked in my previous videos. So Buddha and his Sangha propounded a whole lot of teachings, and those teachings spread over a whole lot of area, and a lot of people learned from them. Now, it is not possible for all of those people to decipher those teachings in the same manner, because one teaching will be something else for one person and something another for another person. So the manifestations of the teachings of Buddha are varied. And because of that, many subsects of Buddhism emerged. And the very first thing happened during the third Buddhist council. I already told you, friends, this third Buddhist council happened under the presidentship of Mogaliputra Tissa. It was under the patronage of King Ashoka in Pataliputra. Okay. Now, what happened in this third Buddhist council? I told you about some two or three important points. First of all, this third Buddhist council held in Pataliputra. First thing that happened here is that Abhidhamma Pitaka was established, completely established in this third council. However, Abhidhamma Pitaka was mentioned in first Buddhist council also, but it was firmly established in the third Buddhist council. So this is one thing which happened in the third Buddhist council, and sects appeared. One such sect was Staviras, friends. This is R-A-S. So one such sect was Staviras. Okay. Also, this was known as Tharvivada. S-T-H-A-R-V-I-V-A-D-A. Okay. And this was also known as Theravada sect, friends. So basically, this Theravada sect of Buddhism, it emerged from the third Buddhist council. Now what happened, friends, when this Buddhist council got over? The complete text of this Buddhist council was, you can dispatch to different places by King Ashok. And one such set went to Sri Lanka also. Most of the teachings were in Pali. Most of the compilation of this third Buddhist council were in Pali. But they were also in other languages. And slowly, slowly, they were translated to Pali. Okay. So, it finally went to Sri Lanka. Slowly, slowly, it developed. And you will see that this Theravada sect of Buddhism, it is present, it is currently active in Sri Lanka, in Cambodia, in Laos, in Thailand, and in present day Myanmar. So these are the countries where Theravada sect is still active. And a slightly different form of Theravada is Hinayana, friends. There is a very small difference between Theravada and Hinayana. However, Hinayana is not actively practiced in many countries. So basically, it is Theravada only. And that is why some people consider Theravada sect to be identical as Hinayana. So they use them interchangeably. That is, they say that Theravada and Hinayana is the same. But they are actually not the same. There are some minor differences in them, but it is not important for us to know that minor differences. You just need to know that Theravada and Hinayana are almost the same things. And what is said in this Theravada or Hinayana sect? One is that the aim of the disciple is to become an arhat. Why an arhat? Because achieving Buddhahood is practically impossible. Being a Buddha is practically impossible according to the Theravada sect, according to the Hinayana sect. So their job, their aim was to become an arhat. They also wanted to achieve spiritual liberation, which was known as Nirvana. But you need to understand, they were aiming for individual Nirvana. So the Hinayana sect followers, the Theravada followers, they were aiming for individual liberation, individual nirvana. Whereas when we will go to Mahayana, there we will talk collective, universal liberation, universal nirvana. But in Theravada, it is individual liberation. In Theravada, it is said that complete Buddhahood is not possible. So that is why people should become an arahat. So this is the basis of Theravada sect, Hinayana sect, which is also known as smaller vehicle friends. Whereas you will able to see the difference between both of these things completely when I will be talking to you about Mahayana. What is Mahayana? Mahayana is also known as the greater vehicle. What happened in the Mahayana sect, friends? In Mahayana, first of all, this Mahayana sect started developing around 1st century BC. So you can see this Hinayana sect was older. The Theravada sect was older. Also, there are some more important facts about Theravada sect. Theravada sect was also known as doctrine of elders. So, also known as doctrine of elders. Then, Ashoka patronized Theravada sect. Second piece of information, which is very important. Individual salvation, individual nirvana, I have already told you when it comes to Hinayana sect. And Pali is the language in which majority of the Theravada text have been written. So this is the important piece of information. Known as Doctrine of Elders, patronized by Ashoka. Pali is the language in which the text of Theravada tradition have been written. And they aim for individual liberation because they believe that achieving complete Buddhahood is not possible. So they aim to become an arahat. It is active in Sri Lanka, Cambodia, Laos, Thailand, Myanmar. When we talk about Mahayana, friends, Mahayana is aiming for universal liberation. It is aiming for universal liberation, which means this Mahayana tradition says that anyone and practically anyone can achieve Buddhahood if he becomes enlightened, if he can control his energy, if he can control his body, if he can control his mind, he can achieve universal liberation. This is being told in Mahayana. Then Zen Buddhism, Tiantai Buddhism, then Tiantai Buddhism, Pure Land Buddhism, Tibetan Buddhism, they are said to be an offshoot of Mahayana Buddhism. Then the concept of Bodhisattvas is associated with Mahayana Buddhism. The 8 important Bodhisattva video I have already uploaded. So this Bodhisattva concept is associated with Mahayana. Okay, one more important piece, friends. In Hinayana, idol worship was opposed. So idol worship was not present in Hinayana, friends, whereas in Mahayana, slight elements of idol worship has been found. So slight elements of idol worship have been found in Mahayana, but in Hinayana, idol worship was literally absent. The language of the Mahayana text is predominantly Sanskrit. So these are the few differences: universal liberation, Bodhisattvas, idol worship, Sanskrit. Okay, so you should understand, friends, that they are aiming for universal liberation because they feel that the society as a whole, the people as a whole, should be liberated from this all things and they should attain spiritual liberation. They should attain Nirvana. So Nirvana was being targeted by both Mahayana and Hinayana, but Hinayana was targeting individual liberation, whereas Mahayana is targeting universal liberation. Okay, so this is the basic difference. You can write it down. It spread to China, it is spread to Tibet. In China, it was slightly mixed with other aspects like Taoist, Confucian. It spread to Korea, Vietnam, also some parts of Cambodia, Laos, then Japan. So it also spread over a very big area, friends. And you need to understand, friends, that for many, many years, the scholars studied in the same university and there were many scholars in the same university who were practicing Hinayana. And some were practicing Mahayana. So in the initial phases, the difference between Hinayana and Mahayana was not big. But slowly, the differences increased and they completely divided. Moving forward, the next thing we are going to talk about is Tantrayana. And this Tantrayana is also known as Vajrayana, as I told in the introductory slide. Now, what is this Tantrayana? In the Mahayana tradition, one is tantric and one is non-tantric. So the tantric practices are followed. Where tantric practices are followed in Mahayana sect, it is known as Tantrayana. And why Tantrayana is then, friends, you need to understand that. First of all, if you have to come into Tantrayana, then you should have a basic knowledge about either Hinayana or Mahayana, and especially Mahayana. And if you are having a good knowledge, you would be first verified by a You can say educated Buddhist philosopher, educated Buddhist expert. And when educated Buddhist expert will refer you, then only you will be eligible to practice Tantrayana. So this is the first thing which you need to remember, friends. Also, that what happens if we practice Tantrayana, if we practice Vajrayana? It is said that tantric practices are very helpful, psychologically very helpful to attain Buddhahood. Psychological element is dominant in Tantrayana. It says that suppose if you are doing worship, so how come you will know that you are becoming Buddha? So if you are going to do tantric practices, psychologically you will be able to believe that yes, I am going towards Buddhahood. And one thing was said at that point of time, the sooner you are going to achieve Buddhahood, the sooner you will be able to help more and more people. Because what is the job of Buddha? What is the job of Bodhisattva? What is the job of Buddhist teacher? It is to teach other people, to help other people, to heal other people. So basically, if you are going to become a Buddha soon, so the sooner you will be able to help people. So that is why Tantrayana emerged. Because Tantrayana said that by deploying tantric practices, you will be achieving Buddha out soon. And if you will become Buddha soon, you will be soon able to help people. So basically, this was Tantrayana. This Tantrayana spread to Ladakh, Sikkim, Nepal, some parts of Mongolia, China, Korea, Japan, and many other countries, friends. So this was the basic difference between Hinayana, Mahayana and Tantrayana, friends. So I hope this video was of a bit help to you, friends. If you have some doubts, you can clarify in the comment section below. If you really like this video, kindly like it, friends. Kindly tell me through your comments that how you like this video. Please subscribe to this channel, friends, and please share these videos on your Facebook and Instagram profile, friends, because that will help me get some amount of views. So thank you for watching, friends. Have a great day. Goodbye.